As we walk west along the beach from the access trail to Wasson Bluff, we'll see rocks from three different geological periods. The rocks in the lower corner to the right are 300-million-year-old sandstones and shales of the Carboniferous period. The great rock on the cliff is 201-million-year-old lava flows, which were hardened to basalt and are from the late Triassic period. As we proceed around the point, we will encounter early Jurassic Age paleo-scree-sloped material, ancient lake bed deposits, and red sandstone sediments, all about 200 million years old. All of these rocks were deformed by tectonic forces during the early Cretaceous period, about 125 million years ago. Let's see the evidence in the rocks.
Welcome everybody to the road access to the Wasson Bluff site. This is a geosite within the Cliffs of Fundy UNESCO Global Geopark, just outside of Parsborough, Nova Scotia. We're here in the Minas Basin on the shores of the Bay of Fundy with the world's highest recorded tides. So come with us and learn, explore, discover, and enjoy Wasson Bluff today. Here we are at the base of the access hill from the road, and what we can see here is Wasson Bluff itself, this basalt headland, 200 million year old volcanic rocks spewed out as the supercontinent Pangaea was starting to separate and the Atlantic Ocean starting to form.
We're halfway around Wasson Bluff now. You can see behind me gray rocks and red rocks. The gray rocks are broken down lava flows from over 200 million years ago. And as they broke down, sands were mixed in with them, blown in, and they often contain fossilized bone material. We're now fully around Wasson Bluff, and you can see behind me several different colors of rock formations. The ones on this side are the broken down lava flows, and the ones on this side are windblown sands that have blown in against the lava flows and also over the lake bed deposits that you see directly behind me. As you can see, the lake beds are at a bit of an angle here. They contain bones of fish and shark teeth and occasional dinosaur material as well in these lake beds. And they're overlain by the red sandstones that were blown in as windblown sand, and they're the ones that contain prosauropod dinosaur remains. They're at an angle now because of faulting and earthquake activity that occurred about 125 million years ago, and it tilted all of the rock formations in this area. And they are now fault blocks that can basically make up the headlands in this area.
Just north of here is one of the major faults that separates northern Nova Scotia from southern Nova Scotia. And this fault is called the Cobblequid-Chetabucto Fault.
On the north side of the Bay of Fundy here, you see that all the basalt outcrops, whether it's Partridge Island or Clark Head or Wasson Bluff or the Brothers or the Five Islands, they're all little isolated bits of basalt, quite different from that continuous sweep of North Mountain going down on the south side of the Bay of Fundy. And why are they isolated? Because they've been chopped up by faults, and they were chopped up by faults in the early Cretaceous.
This area is really fabulous for all sorts of geoscientists. You don't have to be a paleontologist to appreciate this area. As a structural geologist, the type of person that looks at what happens to rocks when they get stressed with faults and folding and things like that, I am fascinated by Wasson's Bluff.
This part of the shoreline is fascinating because at this location you can see several of those huge fault blocks that formed during the faulting 125 million years ago. But they're fault blocks that are made up of beds of sand and silt and clays and muds that were deposited 225 million years ago as North America and Africa began to split apart. As they split apart, rift valleys formed, deposited this material, and then as it split even further, huge lava flows were poured out, massive thickness of lava. And these are recorded from Five Islands behind me all the way through to Briar Island, which is way down the tip of Nova Scotia. And also these lava flows underlay the entire Bay of Fundy, and the massive thickness of lava flows. They were poured out so rapidly that no soil horizons had developed between flows. So it tells us that was a very, very rapid event.
For anybody coming in without a geological background, start here at the Fundy Geological Museum. Find out more about it from the staff. And after that, getting a copy of the geological roadmap of Nova Scotia and looking at all of the different geological sites and the details of this coastline right here.
geological sites and the details of the coastline. The information is there, in the rocks. You can look at the rocks and figure out things for yourself. Being on the shore and finding something. Here it is. You are the first person in the world to see this thing that existed 200 million years ago. That sense of discovery is unbeatable.